I'm Dr. Roberta Shaler, the relationship help doctor, and I do a lot of work considering how to better your relationship if you're having a relationship of any kind with what I call a chronically difficult person. A chronically difficult person is a person who is usually difficult, at least to you, and they're more likely to be difficult at home than anywhere else. In fact, I created a term, I trademarked a term, for people who are chronically difficult, and that term is hijackals and hijackal behavior. And my definition of a hijackal is this: hijackals are people who hijack relationships for their own purposes while relentlessly scavenging them for power, status, and control. Did you get that? Hijackals are people who hijack relationships for their own purposes while relentlessly scavenging them for power, status, and control. That might be your partner, that might be your ex, that might be your mother, that might be your mother-in-law, that might be your boss, that might be your father, that might be your father-in-law. Any number of people that you've met in your life may fall into that category, people with hijackal behaviors and traits. And they work in patterns. So I focus on working with the partners, the exes, and the adult children of chronically difficult people in my practice. And I see people all over the world through the wonderful world of video and the internet. So if you have a hijackal in your life, there are certain things that you want to be able to identify with them. How do you recognize them? Well, they have a few things in common. Ever had the feeling of your hijackal just has to win? That's one of the hallmarks of a hijackal. No matter what, on the smallest thing, the largest thing, they have to win. They have to win in this moment, and this moment, and this moment. And if they don't win, they are petulant and miserable, and they blame you for everything. Okay? That's something a hijackal does. What else do they do? They have extremes of emotion. Something small sets them off in some kind of Roman candle, and you just are unexpected that something so small would have such a large reaction. They just don't have the ability or the willingness to manage their emotions. Another thing that they do is what we call black or white thinking. Now, you know this one because one day you are the best thing that ever happened to them. They love you so much. You are the best thing since sliced bread. Do something they don't like, and all of a sudden, you're the scum of the earth. They don't know why they bothered with you. That's black or white thinking. No gray areas. You're either the best or the worst. And that can change on a dime. Is this beginning to sound a little bit familiar? Another thing that they do is keep you in chaos and uncertainty. They don't want you to feel secure at any moment. How would they get their power and control if you felt secure? So they keep you in that way, and then they do the most amazing things. They say or do something that is absolutely jaw-dropping. You simply go, who does that? Who says those things? And at that moment, because it doesn't fit in any way into some kind of pattern that makes sense to you, you begin to rationalize and justify their behavior. And if you're doing any of those things, that means you're probably responding to a hijackal, and you don't want to be there doing that. You want strategies to do it differently. And if it can't be done differently and they can't get a different response and have a relationship that has some mutuality, some equity, some partnership, then you need to be thinking about what you're going to do with that relationship to move away from the toxicity. So hijackals, they're all around us. They make up about 10-12% of the population that we know about. And some of them are a bit covert, so we don't know about them, but they pop out every now and again, quite unpleasantly. So what can you do? Well, first of all, stop making excuses for them. Stop rationalizing and stop justifying their behavior. They're not having a bad day, a bad moment, or a bad hair day. They are simply that way. And if you look, you will see that it's a pattern with them. So don't take it on anymore, and don't take the fault that they are absolutely going to give and send your way. Everything is going to be your fault because they can't take anything on themselves. Remember that they have to win. So you've got to step back and start looking at the patterns that you're seeing. Patterns that repeat. That's the whole idea of a pattern, right? And reflect honestly on your behavior. Are you really that terrible person that they say you are? Are you really that worthless, not worthy of respect? That person that they demean and they belittle and they tell you that no one would ever want you? No, you're probably not that person at all. And if you just step back, take a breath, and get realistic, get out of the fear, get out of the hypervigilance, and say, am I really that person? You probably find that deep down you're not, and there would be many people who would tell you that you're not, but you're behaving in a way that's responding to the fact that they want you to feel that way. It's not true. It's just what they need in order to feel good about themselves. So see the inequity, see the lack of mutuality, and give your head a shake. Say, is this all right with me? In any way, is this all right with me? And I hope it isn't. It's very difficult to see the patterns when you're in them. And that's why people like me exist, where I can help you see the patterns. I can help you stop responding in ways that are self-deprecating and taking on blame and shame, and stop the games and the manipulation and seduction and the exploitation that happens in these cases. So there's a whole lot that you can do, a whole lot of growing that you can do. And I sincerely hope you'll do it. I have many offerings for you. Come to forrelationshiphelp.com. There's so many things there for you. The blog, the Vital Tips for Relationship newsletter. There's my YouTube channel at For Relationship Help. I have Facebook groups. All of these things are available. So drop by the website and see where all those things are. Download my free ebook, How to Spot a Hijacker. You can get that on forrelationshiphelp.com or just go straight to hijackles.com. We even have a membership site starting very, very soon, and you can be part of that. Maybe by the time you're watching this video, it's already been started. You'll find all of that at forrelationshiphelp.com. I'm Dr. Roberta Shaler, the Relationship Help Doctor, and I look forward to walking through this journey with you and helping you come to a happier, healthier place. Talk soon.